word problems, addition and subtraction. Before we begin our word problem, we want to make sure we have a good problem-solving strategy in place. We're going to read the problem carefully and make sure we understand the problem. We want to know what is being asked in the problem. We're going to think about the problem and think about some strategies we might use to solve it. Once we've thought through the strategies, we'll choose some and we'll make a plan. We're going to plan how to solve this problem so that we have a good plan to execute. We're going to estimate a solution to the problem so we can think about what the answer might turn out to be. We want to make sure that we are having an idea of a reasonable answer. We're going to solve the problem according to our plan, and we're going to look at the answer from our solution to see if it matches what we thought it might be from our estimate. Finally, we're going to double check our answer to make absolutely sure we've made no mistakes along the way. We've put a problem up here to try about a pickup truck. It says the pickup truck could hold 1,000 pounds. There were four objects that were to be picked up. They weighed 256, 135, 315, and 205 pounds. The first question is, what was the total load to be picked up? And the second question is, how much more could the pickup truck carry? I've read the problem through and I want to make sure I understand what's being asked of me. We'd like to know how much this pickup truck could hold in all. It's an empty truck, it can hold up to 1,000 pounds, and we want to make sure that we're not picking up more weight than the truck was designed to carry. The second question asks us, how much more could we possibly put in that truck? Would there be space to pick up another item, and how much could it weigh? I think I understand what the problem is asking me, so I need to come up with a plan. I'm going to think about possible solutions and come up with a plan. If I want to know how much weight the truck is going to be required to carry when I pick up these four objects, I'm going to want to add the weight of those four objects together. That will give me the total weight that the truck will be required to carry. So my plan for question A will be to add up the different weights. My plan for question B is slightly different. It says, how much more could the truck carry? It will already have the weights combined from problem A, and I know that it can carry up to 1,000 pounds, so I'll want to find out if there's any extra space. I'll take the 1,000 pounds and subtract the weight that's already been picked up. Now I have a plan, so I want to do an estimate. When I look at my problem, I'm going to do a very rough estimate to get an idea of what solution I might be expecting to find. 256 pounds is about 250 pounds, and 135 pounds is close to 150 pounds, so 250 and 150 would be 400 pounds. 315 would add about another 300 pounds, so that would be 700 pounds, and 205 would make that about 900 pounds. So I'm going to make a little note down here that says I'm expecting my estimate to be about 900 pounds. If that's the case in the second problem, I know I can carry up to 1,000 pounds, so 1,000 pounds minus the approximate 900 pounds would leave about 100 pounds more that I could possibly pick up. So what I'm going to do is check my problem to see, I'm going to solve my problem to see if these are the answers that I truly come up with. Now, my plan for problem A was to add up the various weights. So what I want to do is add 256, 135 pounds, 315 pounds, and 205 pounds. These are the weights that I want to add together to find out the exact amount that the truck is being required to pick up. I'm going to move to my calculator to do this computation. I'll turn my calculator on and make sure that it's clear, and I'll add up the weights. I have 256 pounds plus 135 pounds plus 315 pounds plus 205 pounds, and it tells me my total is 911 pounds. So I know the total weight that the truck is being required to carry is 911 pounds, pretty close to my estimate of 900. The actual answer is 911 pounds. The second part of my plan requires that I do some subtraction. It says, how much more could the pickup truck carry? I know the pickup truck can carry 1,000 pounds, and it's already being asked to carry 911 pounds. So I'm going to take 1,000 minus 911. I'll come to my calculator. I'm going to clear out the answer and take 1,000 pounds minus 911 pounds. and I see that the pickup truck can carry another 89 pounds. Both of these answers are pretty close to my estimates of 900 pounds and 100 pounds, so I think they're probably right. But I want to make absolutely sure that this is right, so I want to double check my answer. I know that I want the truck to carry a maximum of 1,000 pounds. A way I could check this is to add up the four weights and then also add in 89 pounds. That should total 1,000 pounds, the maximum weight of the truck. So I'm going to add to this list the extra package that I can pick up of 89 pounds, and I'm going to re-add the list just to make sure. So I'll start out by adding 89 pounds, which is already on the calculator, plus 256 pounds, plus 135 pounds, plus 315 pounds, plus 205 pounds. And my total comes out to be 1,000 pounds, the maximum weight that the truck can carry, so I feel confident in my answer. If you follow these steps of understanding, thinking, planning, estimating, solving according to your plan, double-checking your answer, and making sure your estimate and your answer are in alignment, you'll find you have a lot of success with word problems.
As a jet is being unloaded, it is also being fueled. If the jet fuel tank holds 5,275 gallons of fuel and it burns 1,037 gallons of fuel per hour, how many gallons of fuel will the jet have left after flying for 2 hours? Let's do the math. The jet consumes 1,037 gallons per hour, and we want to find out how many gallons of fuel are left after 2 hours of flight. So we can add up 2 hours of fuel consumption, 1037 plus 1037 equals, so it's 2074 gallons in 2 hours. And now we have to find out, the question is, how many gallons of fuel are left? So let's clear the calculator, and we put in the number up here, 5,275 into the calculator, 5,275, and you deduct the amount that was used in 2 hours, 2074 equals, so it's 3,201 gallons of fuel are left. Now there's another way that's a little faster to do it this way. First of all, you put in the gallons that the fuel tank holds and deduct twice this amount. Let's do that in the calculator. Clear it. 5,275 minus 1037, again, minus or deduct, 1037, and equal, it's 3,201 gallons. And so you can find there's different ways of doing the problem, and by thinking, you'll be able to do it the quickest way and the easiest way.
Please pause the video now and complete the problems in your workbook. When finished, press play, and we'll continue with the next lesson.